It's been a while that I promised a video on how to massage the forearm trigger points, which are often involved in lateral epicondylitis, i.e. tennis elbow. So it's more than time that I keep up my promise, and therefore this video. Now, the first thing you need to massage trigger points is a massage ball. Yeah, you can have small massage balls, you can have big massage balls, you can even use a tennis ball, and I even have experience using the champagne cork, which I actually liked quite a lot because it has a linear movement, you know, it moves only in one direction, so you can really follow the fiber of the muscle. When you do trigger point massage, it is important to bear in mind that precision matters much more than pressure, i.e. you don't need to press harder, you need to press better. Better means more precisely, or means with a different wrist position or a different arm position, so that you get between the fibers and that you access the area which will send you referred pain. If you decide to use a small massage ball, be aware that it will go deeper in the tissues, i.e. you need to press less strong than if you use a bigger massage ball. For this video, I will use the big massage ball so that you can see what I do, but in practice, I often use the small one. The best thing I've found is to use a wall for stability. So you see, basically, I will put the ball between the wall and my arm, and my hip joint is resting against my arm. So actually, it's with my legs that I set the pressure. And the idea is that you will follow the muscle fibers, you see, like this, and then move the ball a little to really look for the point that triggers pain in a distant area, typically on your wrist or something. Here, I got one, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in one direction only, yeah? So I press when I go towards my wrist, release, go back, and press again. And I will do this 6 times, more or less, not pressing too strong. And it's really quite important at the beginning that you don't push it too hard, because yeah, that may cause local damage to the tissues. Some trigger points are better accessed when you go, say, distally, that means from the center to the extremities. Some others are better accessed when you go the other way around. For example, in this area, it's easier to go from the wrist to the elbow. Okay, so this is how you choose in which direction you massage. Last but not least, remember that all this is symptomatic treatment. Okay, if you have trigger points in your forearm, it probably means that there's something you do incorrectly with your forearm.